Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
Does it ever make you wonder what's on my mind? I was only ever running back to your side. I never cried, I just watched my life go by. It's just a pack of lies, 'cause you're leaving me behind. Why, after this long, is there nothing I keep? Oh, I can't shout. You pretend you're falling asleep. I live a lie, yeah, believing that you're time, 'cause you're leaving me behind. Hey, there's not a cloud in the sky, it's as blue as your goodbye. And I thought that it would rain on a day like today. Hey, there's not a and I thought that it would break the day you went away. You wonder what's on my mind. Ooh, yeah. I was only ever running back to your side. Hey, there's not a cloud in the sky, it's as blue as your goodbye. And I thought that it would rain on a day like today. Hey, there's not a cloud in sight, it's as blue as your blue goodbye. And I thought that it would rain the day you went away. Thank you.
I'll sit next to you.
Might be with a shade.
Hello, Debbie.
Right there, Lois.
Did you join us in?
Yeah.
Sally King.
Every day's a Sunday.
Does it ever make you wonder what's on my mind? Was only ever running back to your side.
On this fringe back this
I never cried. I just watched my life go by. It's just a pack of lines. Cause you're leaving me behind. After this long, is there nothing I? Oh, I can shout. You'll pretend you're falling loose. I live a lie. Yeah, I believe in that you're mine. It's just a waste of time. Cause you're leaving me behind. There's not a cloud in the sky. It's as blue as your goodbye.
Somebody
and I thought that it would rain on a day like today. Hey, there's not a cloud in sight. It's as blue as your blue goodbye. And I thought that it would rain.
Sandra,
in the day you went away.
Hello, how are you?
Thank you.
Does it ever make you wonder what's on my mind?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. There's an angel contemplate my fate. Do they know the places where we go when we're gray and old? 'Cause I have been told that salvation lets their wings unfold. So when I'm lying in my bed, thoughts running through my head, and I feel that love is dead, I'm loving angels instead. And through it, oh, she offers me protection, a lot of love. Whether I'm right or wrong, and down the waterfall, wherever it may take me, I know that life won't break me. When it comes to call, she won't forsake me. I'm loving angels instead. My pain walks down a one-way street. I look above and I know I'll always be blessed with love. And as the feeling grows, she breathes flesh to my bones. I'm loving angels instead. And through it all, she offers me protection, a love and affection. Whether I'm right or wrong, and down the waterfall, wherever it may take me, I know that life won't break me. When it comes to call, she won't forsake me.
Don't think of him as gone away. His journey has just begun. Life holds so many facets. This earth is only one. Just think of him as resting from the sorrows and the tears in a place of warmth and comfort where there are no days and years. Think how he must be wishing that we could know today how nothing but our sadness can really pass away. And think of him as living in the hearts of those he touched, for nothing loved is ever lost, and he was loved so very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we are gathered here today in remembrance of a very special person in our lives, Mr. Peter Blake. I am Denise Wotherspoon, a civil celebrant, and on behalf of Peter's family, I welcome you, his closest family and friends, and thank you for being with them today to celebrate his life and to say goodbye to him in a meaningful and loving way. To Peter, family meant the world. Father of Tony, Lynn, Debbie, and Darren, deceased. Poppy Pete to Adam, Joshua, Alexander, Kimberly, Matt, Kyle, Clay, Amy Lee, Chloe, Rudy, and Bethany. And the other Poppy to Harrison, Noah, Roscoe, Hunter, Hudson, Andre, Ari, Elke, and Eleanor. He loved them immensely and was extremely proud of them all. I also welcome all who are watching the live streaming of the service today, especially Adam, Kimberly and Kyle, and Peter's brothers, Barry and Des. The family would be honoured if you would join them in the Parkside Reception Centre after the service for refreshments and to share memories of this special man. In a number of ways, Peter's death unites us all. For a time, each of us puts aside our work, our cares, and our busyness to unite ourselves with everyone else here, fellow mourners who share the common bond of love and respect for him. This funeral service serves many purposes. Of course, it is for the reverent farewell of a husband, father, Poppy, other Poppy, brother, cousin, uncle, nephew, and friend. It also recognises the value of his life and confirms that his life has ended. It also helps those remaining to face the reality of his death. Today we stop the rush of life, pause for a while, and reflect. Grief is a passage, not a place to stay. Grief is not a sign of weakness, nor a lack of faith. It's the price of love. When we think about it, none of us have very long on this earth. Life is fleeting. There are people who leave an indelible mark on your soul, an input that can never be erased. Peter was one of these people. Grief is not a disorder, a desire, a disease, or a sign of weakness. It is an emotional, physical, and spiritual necessity, the price we pay for love. The only cure for grief is to grieve. It will be the little things that you remember, the quiet moments, the smiles, the laughter. And although it might seem hard right now, it will be the memories of these little things that can help push away the pain and bring the smiles back again. It is hard to forget someone who gave us so much to remember. Peter was the first of five children born at Smithton on April the 1st, 1937, to French polisher and sawmiller Neil Blake and wife Lorna. Early school years were at Roger River, but later when Neil pursued sawmilling elsewhere, Peter attended school in Ulverston and South Rayanna. He left school at age 15 to fell trees at Lawyertia. Later moving to Burnie, he worked at Vic Clark's bike shop for 2 months before joining AWPM for 12 years as a cutter boy, wet end boy, and dryer. At the age of 21, he lost an arm at the dry end of a paper machine and was seconded to the laboratory. After much rehabilitation and being right-handed, Peter taught himself to write left-handed. He got on with his life, never letting the disability interfere too much. When the grandchildren came along, he bounced them on his right arm, pretending it was a motorbike, much to the amusement of everyone. Around the time of his accident, Peter met a young lady, Margaret, and after impressing her with his motorbike, even though she had to push it on several occasions, they married in 1958 and began their own family. Tony, Lynn, and Debbie were born in succession, and after a gap of 10 years, Darren was born. Totally spoilt by his siblings, sadly, Darren's life was a short one, passing on September the 26th, 2004, age 31. To say that the end of September is an incredibly sad time for the family is an understatement. With the much loved wife and mum Margaret passing on September the 24th, 2010, and now Dad on Thursday morning, September the 23rd. Peter left AWPM in the mid-1970s and took up a position with Golden Crust Bakery, later Bass Bakery, which was then owned by the late Rex Collins and then John Packham. Starting as a delivery man, Peter rose to the position of assistant manager and stayed at Bass Bakery until he retired in 1997. Mr. Packham remarked on Peter's tenacity in looking after the West Coast bread truck, which had special tyres for summer and winter. The truck ended up clocking up 1 million kilometres, thanks mainly to Peter's care and attention. Tony, Lynn and Debbie have many fond memories of rides in the back of the bread truck. Peter's ability as a sports administrator is legendary, both with the Somerset Football Club and the Burnie Athletics Club, where he was secretary for many years, a life member and more recently, club patron. Serving the athletics club for 33 years, he had two stints as secretary for 15 and 20 years, respectively. While at Bass Bakery, Peter became a firm friend of the late Mr. Rex Collins, who was a staunch Burnie Rotarian, and his influence led Peter to become a founding member of the Somerset Rotary Club. Peter was heavily involved with the Somerset Club from the outset. As community service chairman on the inaugural board in 1980-81, and the following year as club service chairman. Other board roles included vice president, 90-91, president-elect, 91-92, president, 92-93, and immediate past president, in 93-94. Peter held the role of treasurer of the club for 8 years during the 1980s, and then for 17 straight years from 1997 to 2014, ruling the club's finances with an iron fist. Club historian Alan Leeson described Peter as a sometimes gruff, matter-of-fact character, who never sought any favours and never reneged when asked to contribute. Peter was presented with a Paul Harris Fellowship in 1995-96 and a Sapphire Pin in 2005-2006. Having introduced and organised the hole-in-one golf competition for many years, he raised thousands of dollars for community projects. He was also editor of the club magazine, The Cog, for 5 years, producing 247 issues. Peter received a special citation on February the 22nd, 2018, after almost 4 decades of attending every Thursday night meeting, never missing any, a true 100%er. On November the 28th, 1998, Peter received the Tasmania Day Award in recognition of his service to the community and his contribution as a sports administrator. Peter was also a member of Probus and the Wynyard Historical Society and volunteered at the Wonders of Wynyard. A hard-working and stoic family man, he loved a beer with his mates, later a red wine, loved attending the store gift every Easter with Margaret and heading up to the shack at the lakes to get away from it all whenever they got the chance. Tony, Lynn and Debbie shared wonderful memories with me of times spent with their dad. Tony fondly remembered his trip to Melbourne with dad. Lynn recalled why she decided not to eat lamb after one of their pets disappeared from the menagerie in Somerset and came home in a box. And Debbie had great memories of rides in the Statesman in Chudley. They all laughed as they fondly remembered the Sunday treat, a small glass of beer each when they returned from Sunday school. Sometimes on our journey through life, we meet people who leave footprints on our mind. They challenge us to see things differently and to question our personal reality. Sometimes on our journey through life, we meet people who leave footprints on our heart. They create a safe place for us to open our hearts to feel loved and special. Then sometimes on our journey through life, we meet people who leave footprints on our souls. They share themselves with us so profoundly that they touch the very essence of who we are in that secret, quiet space. Peter has left gentle footprints on the minds, hearts, and souls of all of you here today. May we always remember the beauty of his love, his kindness, and the special way he touched our lives. It is now time to lay our father, Poppy Pete, other Poppy, and friend to rest. Simon will give you flowers. When you are ready, please feel free to come forward and place the flowers on Peter's coffin and say your quiet goodbye.
To hear your voice, see your smile, sit and talk with you a while, to be together the same old way, that would be our greatest wish today. To hear you laugh, to hear you cry, and just a chance to say goodbye, to say the things we didn't say, that would be our greatest wish today. But all we can do is throw a flower on the water, look for the sun through the rain, lay a little frangipani gentle on the water, remember how we loved you. To comb your hair, lace your shoes, buy some flowers, let you choose. A phone call when you're away, just to see if you're okay. To hear your voice, see your smile, to sit and talk with you a while, to be together the same old way, that would be our greatest wish today. But all we can do is throw a flower on the water, look for the sun through the rain. Lay a little frangipani gentle on the water. Remember how we loved you. Remember how we loved you.
We commit the body of Peter Blake to the elements. These are the last rites in the natural life of our husband, father, brother, Poppy, cousin, uncle, and friends. Tenderly and reverently, we commit the body of Peter to Mother Earth, from which all life comes and to which all life returns, reunited with Margaret. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, grateful for the life that has been lived and for all that life has meant to us. May we resolve that while we live, we will still strive with all our might to make our living of real worth. In the blink of an eye, everything can change. So forgive often and love with all your heart. Now, thinking of him, let us leave this place in quietness of spirit and live with love and concern for one another, as Peter would want us to do. Please feel free to reconvene in the refreshment centre to share your memories of Peter with family and friends. Thank you.
Make you wonder what's on my mind. I was only ever running back to your side. I never cried, I just watched my life go by. just a pack of lies, 'cause you're leaving me behind. After this song is there nothing else? Oh, I can shout. You'll pretend you're falling asleep. I live a lie. Yeah, I believe in that you're mine. It's just a waste of time, 'cause you're leaving me behind. Hey, there's not a cloud in the sky. It's as blue as your goodbye. And I thought that it would rain on a day like today. Hey, there's not a cloud in sight. It's as blue as your blue goodbye. And I thought that it would rain the day you went away. Hey, does it ever make you wonder what's on my mind? Running back to your side. Hey, there's not a cloud in the sky. It's as blue as your goodbye. And I thought that it would rain on a day like today. Hey, there's not a blue as your blue goodbye, and I thought that it would rain.